people, it's me, Duke CT here at the at a very interesting place. I am at a reenactment, basically celebrating here with my dad. Wave hi to the camera. Yes. I'm right here. I'm looking at the reenactment with me and him, because we'd like to spend some time together. He's taking some camera pictures and everything, all the, you know, the Civil War and everything, American Civil War. Also, you know what I'm wearing, people? A Confederate hat. And you know why I'm wearing a Confederate hat? Because I'm bizarre.
Oh. the brothers, and may he plow the soil, fighting for the property we gained by honest toil. And when our rights were threatened, the cry rose near and far, hurrah for the bonny blue flag that bears a single star. Hurrah, hurrah, for Southern rights, hurrah, hurrah for the bonny blue flag that bears a single star. First gallant South Carolina nobly made the stand. Then came Alabama and took her by the hand. Next quickly Mississippi, Georgia and Florida, all raised on high the bonny blue flag that bears a single star.
Hurrah!
Hurrah! Hurrah! For Southern rights, hurrah! Hurrah! For the bonny blue flag that bears a single star. Ye men of valor, gather round the banner of the right. Texas and fair Louisiana, join us in the fight. Davis, our good president, and Stephen, statesmen are, all rally round the bonny blue flag that bears a single star.
Hurrah!
Hurrah! Hurrah! For Southern rights, hurrah! Hurrah! For the bonny blue flag that bears a single star. Then here's to our Confederacy, strong we are and brave. Like patriots of old, we'll fight our heritage to save. And rather than submit to shame, to die we would prefer. So cheer for the bonny blue flag that bears a single star.
Hurrah!
Hurrah! Hurrah! For Southern rights, hurrah! Hurrah! For the bonny blue flag that bears a single star. Then cheer, boys, cheer, raise a joyous shout, for Arkansas and North Carolina now have both gone out, and let another rousing cheer for Tennessee be given.
And so dedicated can long endure. We are met on a great battlefield of that war. We have come to dedicate a portion of that field as a final resting place for those who here gave their lives that that nation might live. It is altogether fitting and proper that we should do this. But in a larger sense, we cannot dedicate, we cannot consecrate, we cannot hallow this ground. The brave men, living and dead, who struggled here, have consecrated it far above our poor power to add or detract. The world will little note nor long remember what we say here, but it can never forget what they did here. It is for us, the living, rather to be dedicated here to the unfinished work which they who fought here have thus far so nobly advanced. It is rather for us to be here dedicated to the great task remaining before us, that from these honored dead, we take increased devotion to that cause for which they gave the last full measure of devotion. That we here highly resolve that these dead shall not have died in vain, that this nation, under God, shall have a new birth of freedom, and the government of the people, by the people, for the people, shall not perish from the earth.
Woo!